I am truly amazed that I was able to clear out the Mythic Dawn all on my own. Well, I had a little help from my Dremora that I kept on summoning, but that still counts as me. I could have summoned my friends in to help as well, especially with the shrine area, but I chose not to. I wanted to do this on my own because I cannot always rely on my companions to support me. Fortunately, I was able to handle it well. Some of it was difficult, but I did all right for myself. As for the Argonian that I sacrificed, I felt nothing. Murdering him was a means to an end that I would do all over again if given the choice. It allowed the group of them to think all was well and to walk away. That is what I needed, and I don't regret it, though it was the first person that I've sacrificed. What I'm more concerned with was that by doing that pathetic ritual that I am now in some way bound to Maroon's Dagon. However, when I took the book, the Mysterium Xerxes, the statue of Maroon's Dagon broke and fell apart. So I hope that whatever I did by taking the book undid any connection I might have had with that Daedric Prince. I felt within my element. It wasn't the combat that I relished, it was the feeling of power. Power over fools that are trying to bring destruction to our world. They kept on saying the great cleansing is coming, and that the Daedric Prince himself will soon walk Tamriel. That cannot come to be. If it does, then it's our end. So I will fight against any and all of these Mythic Dawn lackeys until I cannot fight anymore. I have their book, and they have the Amulet of Kings. I do not know if this was a good or bad trade. We will need that amulet to prevent the gates from opening. I hope that something within the book helps, or we will be in for a lot of trouble. Already, gates are popping up around the province. Something will have to be done, and I do not want to go in and close them all. All right, we've gotten our horses. Well, most of us have. Come on. We can't tarry. We will have to go. We have to go. Return to Cloud Ruler Temple. Taking the road. I think I should cut across to this road. Go straight west, but I don't know how the mountains will be. We're actually going to be getting away from mountains going this way. Well, I'll follow this little trail here. Fought enough of these cultists, know that there are a lot of trouble. Goblins. This is the cave where we're at. Shoot me with an arrow, are you? Tough creature. Mushrooms. Velia. Just keep going. Get in your horse. We'll keep going. It's nothing. Running from these Mythic Dawn, now we're running from goblins. Must keep going west. No matter what kind of terrain it is. Well, if it's too steep, it's too steep. But it seems like going up the hillside or mountainside right now. City's just down this way. You see the bridges. boar down there. Goblins. A bunch of them. Try to avoid things like that. I don't want to keep stopping all the way back to defend myself. Cloud Ruler Temple. We are coming. We are coming. Deer.
I'm a bit thirsty. I wouldn't mind a drink.
Keep going. There's a gate right there. Okay. We're at the road. Now we'll know who's Mythic Dawn agent by whoever's screaming at us and running at us with their weapons. Yeah, and that could be Frostcrag Spire. I don't know. But I do know that I want to return to Shadenhall, the area at least. A few things I'd like to do in. Around there. And we've been doing this all night, and I am actually quite tired. Now that I feel like I'm calming down. Okay, well, things should be okay. Let's get to Cloud Ruler Temple. Well, we run into a few gates. And I think I've taken the wrong way. I found a cave. This is not where I want to be. So, let's return. Cloud Ruler Temple is just up there. There's a pass by the path going up. Well, that's not the way up. This way. This way. Here. Where are those?
There's someone watching me. I can tell.
We're almost there to the path. Here. This way. Yes, there was more Oblivion Gates on the way. I saw two more. One seemed right in the wilderness. Very odd. And we managed to come across a brigand who had a elven bow, which I gave to Lilia. Wind. Okay, open the gate. Joffrey.
Thank Talos you've returned safely. Do you have the amulet?
No. Makar Cameron escaped with it.
Please tell me you have some good news.
Maybe. I have the Mysterium Xarxes.
Ah, good. You should take that to Martin right away. He'll be in the Great Hall reading. He's hardly taken time to sleep since you left.
It was some days ago. He should have rested well enough. Is that the tower? It's a tower from here.
Yes.
I believe that it's been left to me. I'm going to have to go and see to that place. I guess I could go see it and then go back to Shadenhall. And actually, Azura's Shrine is one of the places I wanted to visit. Go there, and then go to Macamentane, which is down here. On the map, it's right by the A of the basin, Nibene Basin. Little town, Silverfish Falls. Okay, so Martin wants a book. Well, I've looked at it briefly. Yeah, it's obviously written in Daedric. I can translate a few of the symbols, but much of it is gibberish to me, actually. My specialty was Aelid Ruins, not Aelidun, is what I can read. I can't really read the language of the Daedra.
Yes?
Martin. Emperor Martin.
Ah, you're back. I told Joffrey not to worry. I can see you've had bad news. You didn't recover the amulet, did you?
No, but I have the Mysterium Xerxes.
By the Nine! Such a thing is dangerous even to handle! Forgive me. You were right to bring it. But you'd better give it to me. I know some ways to protect myself from its evil power.
Can the Xerxes lead us to Cameron?
I don't know. Maybe. I suspect that the secret of how to open a portal to Cameron's paradise lies within these pages. But I will need time. Tampering with dark secrets, even just reading them, can be very dangerous. I'll have to proceed carefully. In the meantime, you should speak to Joffrey. He was concerned about reports of spies in Bruma.
So you're familiar with Daedric magic, then?
I put aside the dark arts when I became a priest. The workings of fate may be seen in this too. The gods can turn anything to good, or so I piously told those who came to see me for advice. Perhaps I may yet come to believe it myself.
You used to be a cultist of some Daedric Prince, weren't you? Anyways, Mysterium Xerxes, what do you know about it?
This evil book was written by Mehrunes Dagon himself, and given by him to Manka Cameron.
Yes, I was told that.
I believe Manka Cameron used it to create his paradise. It should give us the means to open a gate there ourselves.
Create his paradise.
I will continue studying it.
So he's created his own Oblivion Plane. Odd. Do you know about Oblivion Gates? How to open them and how to close them?
It is now clear to me that the only way to stop the Oblivion invasion is to relight the Dragonfires.
Hmm.
Emperor, Amulet, and Dragonfire. With these divine gifts, the Daedra of Oblivion have been kept at bay for thousands of years. While the Dragonfires burned, the divine barriers kept the Daedra from making more than fleeting visits to our world. But the Dragonfires can only be relit by an heir of the Septim blood, wielding the Amulet of Kings. This was the essence of Manka Cameron's plot. He was undone only by the merest chance. But his complete victory remains perilously close. We must recover the Amulet of Kings and relight the Dragonfires before it is too late to stem Dagon's invasion.
Yes, I fully agree.
I hope to have at least part of the Mysterium Xerxes translated in a few days. Speak to Joffrey about the spies in the meantime.
The Amulet of Kings. The Amulet of Kings by Wenengrius Monhana. What a name. In the first years of the First Era, a powerful race of elves called the Aelids, or the Heartland High Elves, ruled central Tamriel with an iron hand. The high and haughty Aelids relied on their patrons, the treacherous Daedra lords, to provide armies of Daedra and dead spirits. With these fearless, magical armies, the Aelids preyed without mercy upon the young races of men, slaughtering or enslaving them at their whim. On behalf of the suffering human races, Saint Alessia, the first in the line of Cyrodiils, sought the aid of Akatosh, the dragon god of time, and ruler of the noble Aedra. Akatosh, looking with pity upon the plight of men, drew precious blood from his own heart and blessed Saint Alessia with this blood of dragons, and made a covenant that so long as Alessia's generations were true to the dragon blood, Akatosh would endeavor to seal tight the gates of Oblivion and to deny the armies of Daedra and undead to their enemies, the Daedra-loving Aelids. In token of this covenant, Akatosh gave to Alessia and her descendants the Amulet of Kings and the Eternal Dragonfires of the Imperial City. Thus does Alessia become the first gem in the Cyrodiilic Amulet of Kings. The gem is the red diamond in the middle of the amulet. This is the symbol of the Empire, and later taken as the symbol of the Septim Line. It is surrounded by 8 other gems, one for each of the divines. So long as the Empire shall maintain its worship of Akatosh and his kin, and so long as Alessia's heirs shall bear the Amulet of Kings, Akatosh and his divine kin maintain a strong barrier between Tamriel and Oblivion, so that mortal man, need never again fear the devastating summons hosts of the Daedric Lords. But if the Empire should slacken in its dedication to the Nine Divines, or if the blood of Alessia's heirs should fail, then shall the barriers between Tamriel and the Daedric realms fall, and Daedric worshippers might summon lesser Daedra and undead spirits to trouble the races of men. He was right about all of it, except for thousands of years, because of the Plainmeld attempt by Molag Bal in the middle of the Second Era. It was approximately 1,000 years ago. Well, I am tired. I'm gonna go to sleep, and when I wake up, I have a lot of potions to create. And please stop whistling. I don't know if you're whistling at me or Vilya. Okay, well, it's early in the morning, so I'm to create some potions. Valrus! Nice to see that he made it here. It's a little chilly out. Maybe I'll go in the main hall.
Good morning, sir.
Morning. Martin asked me to speak to Joffrey about Mythic Dawn agents spying on Cloud Ruler Temple. Yes, I imagine there's quite a few of them, actually. I will make my potions right here, then.
What can I do for you? Love. I don't believe in it. Not anymore.
Love? Don't believe in it. Joffrey, I hate to wake you.
I hope Martin knows what he's doing with that evil book. I fear for what it could do to him if he's not careful.
All right, so I see Valrus is back, alive and safe.
I'm glad to have Boris here. He guards Martin night and day. His way of atoning for the death of Emperor Uriel, I suppose.
Good to hear. What about these spies that are watching Cloud Ruler Temple?
Ah, yes, I hope you can help. The gate guards have reported seeing strangers on the road for the past several nights. I cannot leave Cloud Ruler undefended while my men search the whole mountainside, but these spies must be eliminated.
Well, find these spies.
Thank you. Talk to Stefan. He can tell you where he has seen them. Captain Bird in Bruma may also be able to help. I've asked the Countess to have the guard keep an eye out for strangers. Track down the spies and kill them. Find out what they know and what they're planning, if possible.
Gladly.
I'm counting on you to eliminate those spies. We can't afford to let the Mythic Dawn operate out of Bruma with impunity.
Yes. I completely understand, and I would do it.
Good morning, sir.
Even if you didn't order me to do it. Okay. So, I found Fergus some armor, and they said they don't mind. Ooh, this must be Martin's room. Very nice. Nicest place you'll find here. Okay, so who was I to go? What was his name? Stefan of the Blades. Is there a Stefan here? Stefan?
What can I do for you, sir?
I'm supposed to track down spies. That are Mythic Dawn spies that are watching Cloud Ruler Temple.
We always see them near the Rune Stone at dusk. They aren't too woodcrafty, but Grandmaster Joffrey has forbidden us to range too far from the walls. But it seems that you have been given the freedom to attack the enemy that we all crave. Good luck. We will keep the Emperor safe here. Don't worry.
Heard any good rumors lately?
The Emperor's death was a harsh lesson for all of us. We failed in our duty to the Dragonborn. It must not happen again.
No. No, it must not happen again. If it does, we're all dead. Well, it's a little past dawn, I think, but I will still go and see. I do remember seeing a dead guard down there by the stone, if it's in the same place that I saw coming up. It's right around the corner and down the hill. We missed dawn by a few hours. Or did he say dusk? Doesn't matter.
How are you today?
Hey. Let's go. I'll go to Bruma and talk to the guard captain there afterwards. Who's this? Who are you and what are you doing on the road?
What?
What are you doing here? Not talking
to
him. He does
me for asking,
look more like a bandit.
Are you sure that you know where we are going?
Yes, I know where we're going, Vilya. It's right around the corner. I swear I saw a dead guard there. Right here. Well, I'll go see if there's anything. I'd have to wait around here for dusk to come. You did say dusk, right? Near the runestone at dusk, so yeah, it's quite a bit past that time. Wormwood. Motherwort. Alright, so I did see the guard here. That's a Bruma scout. Silver arrows. No point in letting it go to waste. Now, who is this? I have no idea. It's just a Nord man. With very little on him, that excites me, so... What else did he say? Captain Bird of the Bruma Guard might know of any strangers in town. Well, I guess that we'll have to do that now.
How do you do?
Okay, we're gonna go inside Bruma. Very cold. That's my tower, I guess. It's pretty epically tall. While I'm here in town, I guess I'll sell my potions. Okay, well, let's go find this Captain Bird. Well, he's not Captain Bird, but I'll ask him anyways. Do you know of any strangers in town?
Not on my watch. Captain Bird will know for sure, though. We all report to him.
Heard any good rumors lately?
The Fighters Guild thing at Desolate Mine went perfectly, didn't it? They cleared out the goblins, and no one got hurt.
Surprised anyone's talking about that. Okay, then. Directions...
What are you looking for?
I saw the two guilds already, so... Where are the services?
The general trader and clothier and armorer are on the terraces to the west. The smith is north, next to the wall.
Hear that incessant howling outside. It's rather terrifying, actually. Yes, this place is full of Nords. More Nords here than anyone else, actually. Olaf's tack and tap. Not another cat gone crazy again. Oh, this looks more like an inn than anything else. Anyways, let's go find the Captain Bird.
You leave my friend alone, you bastards!
I guess we found our Mythic Dawn spy. The Mythic Dawn agent named Jurl is dead. I should continue to search for other spies and locate their base in Bruma. Perhaps I should speak to Captain Bird, as Joffrey suggested. Well, I'd love to, but we're being attacked as soon as we left the inn. As Jurl has a key, basement key. I found a key marked basement key. Perhaps this clue can help me locate a Mythic Dawn agent base in Bruma. Captain Bird may be able to provide more information about suspicious activity. Well done, actually. There's a red guard.
At your earliest convenience.
The Countess requests my company. What is this regarding?
Countess Carbane would prefer if you speak to her in person. She also said to present you with this stipend as a taste of things to come. My lady holds court from 8 in the morning until 6 in the evening each day. That would be the best time to see her.
Undoubtedly. What can you tell me about Countess Carvane?
The Countess is in attendance from 8 in the morning until 6 in the evening each day.
You do like repeating yourself.
If you wish to seek audience with her, please return at that time. You're also welcome to wait anywhere in the Great Hall. Good day.
I heard they have dropped and he seems to know what's going on. Although, as usual, he speaks only...
It's a battle mage, I take it.
Prophets always spare a coin for the infirm.
Yes. Okay, where's the castle? Persuasion, wheedling, cajoling, and coercing are all tools of speechcraft. They are tools I seek to excel in. I'm now an apprentice of speechcraft. Now, let's sell these potions, shall we?
Need new clothing? I have a fantastic selection.
Actually, I think I've found the wrong person, but... Thank you.
Good day.
Perhaps I could sell to him. Anyways, we'll find it. Hello?
I'm sorry. You must speak to Countess Carvane for any further information.
Oh yes, you're the one that sent me here. Hello?
I've heard much about your deeds from my people in Bruma. I trust the stipend Tolgan gave you whetted your appetite.
Of course it did. Yes, that's why I'm here.
Good point. Allow me to formally introduce myself. I'm Countess Narina Carvane. I assume you've noticed all the Akaviri relics I'm displaying. Well, it's safe to say I'm a collector of sorts. I've invested a great deal of time and money acquiring these bits of ancient history. In fact, I'd be so bold as to proclaim my collection the most complete in all Cyrodiil, perhaps even beyond. Except for one thing. A particular relic has eluded me for many years. Possessing this piece of Akaviri antiquity would make my collection complete. I'm of course referring to the Draconian Madstone.
Draconian Madstone. Okay, tell me about this Draconian Madstone.
The stone is a fine bit of Akaviri craftsmanship. Worn like an amulet, this talisman is said to protect the wearer from poisons of any type. The Madstone appears as a snake coiled around and encircling itself. The eyes of the snake are supposed to be precious gems or some such. Through my sources, I've learned that the last reported location of the Madstone was the ruins at Pale Pass.
Pale Pass? How do I remember that name? Where is Pale Pass?
Are you familiar with the history of Pale Pass?
Sounds familiar. Wasn't that where Emperor Reman met the Akaviri forces when they came in their first invasion? I think I do know about it.
Well then, history lesson notwithstanding, I hope you can recover the Draconian Madstone.
Okay, I will see about getting you this Draconian Madstone.
If you retrieve the Draconian Madstone for me, I'll be happy to compensate you by rewarding you with another Akaviri artifact. Are you game?
I suppose so, yes.
I had a feeling you'd accept. Good. Then let me tell you how you're going to find the Madstone. I've come into the possession of a diary, written by an Akaviri messenger. I suspect that the text within can lead you to the ruins. Here's a translation of the passages we could still read. It was quite damaged. I've also included a rough map that was drawn in the diary as well. I'm also providing you with a unique key that was supposedly found with the diary. I'm assuming it'll prove useful when you arrive at the site.
A diary, map, and key. You give me everything. Okay, so... have you heard about strangers in town?
Not that I can think of. People are mostly staying home, what with all the troubles in the world.
Yes, kind of understandable. Heard any good rumors lately?
There's been trouble with smugglers and Khajiit bandits in the Transnibbon, but Marius Caro is taking steps to deal with the problem.
Hmm. Can you tell me about Bruma?
Some see only the conflicts between northern and southern cultures, but I see the way they are stronger when woven together.
Thank you.
May the path
return
ahead be free of danger.
And with the Madstone. an attractive Imperial woman. Very attractive. For some reason, I thought she'd be a Nord. I don't know why. Now, where is this captain?
Hi there.
Yeah, this
is
him.
Have you heard any word about the other provinces?
Hello?
Lieutenant Gerrit Senerel of the Bruma Guard.
I'm looking for Captain Bird, and I can't seem to find him anywhere in town. What can you tell me about Bruma?
As Captain Bird says, we have to stay on the good side of the local Nords. It ain't their fault they're ignorant barbarians.
Hey.
What?
I guess Nords kind of have that reputation. Yes, I'll keep on looking for this Captain Bird. I have no idea where he is. Hello?
Hello!
Heard Captain Bird's in the barracks.
Have you heard about the attack on the chapel? The servants of Debella.
I do.
Slaughtered on the very altar of love. Truly shocking.
By the gods!
Indeed. I'm Hello? Captain Bird, commander of the Bruma Guard.
I've been told to come see you. I am looking for Mythic Dawn spies.
Except for Jurl coming back from a trip down south, things are pretty quiet. Not much travel right now with the Oblivion Crisis. I've told my men to keep a sharp eye out, but I've had no reports of any strangers in town. What about you? Turned up anything suspicious?
Yes, I have. I was attacked by Mythic Dawn agent. Jurl was her name. She was the Mythic Dawn agent.
God's blood! So she was the spy? Seems there's no one you can trust these days. Since you're working with Cloud Ruler Temple, I'm going to authorize you to search Jurl's house. I'll pass the word to my men. We won't interfere.
Okay. Do you know, have you heard anything more about any other spies? Any other suspicious activity?
I trust that you'll handle things appropriately. The less I know about it, the better.
Okay. Can you tell me about Bruma?
I make sure my guards treat the local Nords and their ways with respect.
As they should. Heard any good rumors lately?
Apparently, Rightwind teaches his blade skills to other Fighters Guild members.
Ah, yes, the guilds.
Be seeing you.
I'll have to return here. One place at a time. Okay, well, let's go see this person's home. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.